Right, thank you. May I invite the congregation to rise and just say, this is a day. This is a day, okay. Let's sing that song. This is a day, this is a day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. This is a day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. This is a day. This is a day that the Lord has made. Please be seated. I want you to relax a little bit. I am new to the North American mission ministry or mission activity. Except by God's grace, I'm also blessed to learn from the context that I'm working with my brothers, Pastor Dave and Trevor at St. Luke Lutheran Church. Prior to the merge of Christ Lutheran Church in Lansing and Hazlett, I was the senior pastor in downtown Lansing. And that is where real experience that I acquired a new experience about what mission is. Let me tell you, 1989, when we settled in Toronto to do the same ministry with the English District Missouri Synod, our congregation in downtown Toronto was St. John Lutheran Church, an old church, a First World War, or the 20th century congregation of German background. But as we all know and experience, churches are born, raised, grow and decline. But God's word never grow old and decline. It is there. When we came there, ministry was very different for us. Let me give you an example. The first day that I preached in that congregation, and doing the liturgy at the during the collection or the offering, one of the elders on the side of the altar said, "Pastor, hurry up, we want to take the offering, okay? We want to take offering so that the counters can count it." I said, "Wait. You know, in our liturgy, during the offering time, all the gifts that God gave us are brought to the altar. And here is also all the gifts from God, not only the word, but the sacraments. We bring our offering from what He gave us, and He comes abundantly with a great gift of the body and blood of His Son." Then one of the elders said, "Pastor, it is a custom that we should whisk it inside, take it out so that the elders may very fast count on it and close and go." Wow. This is what mission is. We come with the things that God equipped us. And we bring our power, our strengths, our life, our strengths or talent and resources. That is the prayer. The prayer is, we thank you, God, for the life that you have given us, the life which is yours in us, the strengths, the talent that you gave us, and the resources, whether it is money, gold, or silver, we bring it here. And He comes with greater gifts of that. This is what mission is. This is what mission is. And this is a liturgical prayer of the whole church. Not the pastor only, but we all say this prayer. You have given us power, strength. You have given us mind, heart. You have given us gold and silver. And we bring it here back to you. And you have come to us also. So we are equally yoked there with the mighty God. And today, my friends, let me affirm before you, saying, there is no place in the whole universe where God cannot do his mission. You go to the, if possible, if God can take us to the whole universe, even the galaxies, there is no place that God cannot do his mission. If we know what we have received from him, and if we are willing to bring what he gave us to where he is, mission is not our plan. Mission is not our strategy. Mission is not our will. Mission is something that we receive, and it is something that we are entrusted. We become co-workers with the mighty God who is in mission with us. And his mission is that all may be saved. I have been in 7 countries, 3 continents. I lived, worked, and schooled in 7 countries, 3 continents. And this is what I know about mission. I have been listening to my friends. What a blessing that God gave us these opportunities to reach the community. And today, my friends, I don't want to discourage you. There is something. The things that we do, even the world can do. Atheists can do. Those who do not believe in Jesus Christ, in the mighty God, those who do not believe in Trinity can do it. But there is one thing that they cannot do. They cannot do the mission of our Almighty God, the Father of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. They cannot do that. This is what should make us happy and rejoice and continue to be strong. And never be disappointed also if we don't succeed to do the mission or see the mission that we do being accomplished and come to the top. Someone will do it if we cannot finish it. All we have to do is to tell our people, the faithful, the saints, the people of peace, to come to the table of mercy and receive, give and receive this task from the one who gives us this mission. I'm an Eritrean in East Africa, one of the ancient Christian countries, the Orthodox Church. My lineage is way back, a priestly line. I'm not boasting. Orthodox Church, liturgically very rich church in the continent of Africa. If you know Ethiopia and Eritrea, the church was there from the time of the apostles and the church fathers. Life there among the people is liturgical. Everything is liturgical. When I say liturgical, man comes to God. Everything that we do, the way we greet, the way we dress, the way we communicate each other, the way we live, is biblical. And the church is the court of peace. Today, if you go to Eritrea or Ethiopia, the church is a court of peace where it is open 7/24. the lights in the Holy of Holies, or the candles in the Holy of Holies, are always lit. There are pastors or priests there. Hourly prayers are conducted every day. The seniors, those who are homebound, or what we call them here, the seniors, and each and everybody, they come and the church is open. A lot of operation. A lot of service is done there. The mission of the church, God's gift, is freely given. And there is this court of peace. Thanks, I see many of our congregations, the facilities are as big as this, very spacious, that we can do many kinds of ministries, right? People come. There is an hourly prayer there, morning, noon, evening, midnight. Even the farmers, when they come from the fields, they have time to go to the church for meditation, reflection, prayer. And if you come to the court of peace, there are the catechumens. Children are drilled under the learned priests. They learn. They are catechized. The seniors come. They listen, contemplate, and reflect. There is always responsive prayer and chanting. The sick are there. There is exorcism in the quarters there. The passerby, the hungry, they come. There is always food there. The villagers, they bring food to share. This is not meant only for the poor, but to share with the haves and the not haves. This is the church of peace. Fugitives, they come. Refugees, they come. When I say refugee, not political refugees, but refugees who are peccatus. Until their case is brought to the elders of the community, they take shelter there. And with the intervention of the church, and those who are in blood feud, and reconciliation takes place, they are there. Sheltered, protected. Many activities. Today, if we come to our church at St. John, Christ Campus, St. Luke Christ Campus, with whom are we interacting? Our church is, I'm not bragging, but our church is doing this kind of work. It is a court of peace. Sparrow Hospital is there, where it treats physically sick people. We have a Rite Aid pharmacy, which sells the prescribed medicines from that hospital. And here is our church. Every time people are picked by the police or ambulance, they are brought to the emergency. And they put them in the emergency rooms. They keep them overnight. And you can see people trekking toward the church. They ring the bell or knock the door and they say, "Pastor, I have been at the hospital. I have prescription. I'm hungry." And you know how we know? They have a watch in their hands. That is the level that they put at the emergency. That's their witness. Very hungry, very sick, very lonely, no place to go. What do you do with these people? What do I do with these people? What is the mission of the church with such people? Every Saturday, we have a five-course meal. Not only soup, but five-course meal for people who come there. And we feed. God has given us the grace to share this food with an average of 120 people every Saturday. Then groceries are also distributed. They take groceries also every Saturday. And people come. People come. You know what they say? Am I killing your time?
You are killing.
Okay.
We love you.
Okay. Okay. We do this. For the sick, we have a cooperation with the medical school of the University of Michigan. And we have coat bank, food supply, and all this. Why do we do all this mercy work? Because we are there, given to give. But most of all, our ministry is the involvement of the whole congregation. It is not the mission committee or few people, but it is everybody's. We, as I have said, it is everybody's task. We come with our strengths, we come with our talent, we come with our life, and we give it and share it. The handout that I gave you is an information how this court of peace in Eritrea among the in the Orthodox Church works, and that is the replica that a kind of replica or imitation that we are working in our church. Thank you for listening to me, but I had the tendency that 15 minutes is much, but.